Hello, and welcome to another of my Kubuntu 11.04, codenamed Natty Narwhal, tutorials. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you some of the basic programs that come with Kubuntu. To start, go to the K menu in the bottom left corner of the screen. From this menu, you can access your applications and documents, just like the Start menu in Windows, the Dash in Unity, or the menus in GNOME. It's arranged into five categories. Favorites is the default category. It contains links to anything you wish. When you install Kubuntu, it contains some of the most popular pre-installed applications. Any menu item may be added to favorites using its right-click menu. For example, I can add pop-up notes by right-clicking its icon and clicking Add to Favorites. The second category is applications. It contains an orderly tree of the applications installed on your computer. Kubuntu already comes fully equipped for the needs of most computer users, with a web browser called Reconk, an office suite called Libreoffice, which is based on the OpenOffice.org project by Sun, a music library called Amarok, a video player, and of course a file manager. Next is the computer category, which contains important items for managing your computer, including a link to the system settings, software management tool, and several other commonly used locations on your computer. After this is the recently used category. Over time, it will fill with files and applications. You can use this category for quick access to files you use often. Finally, we have the Leave menu, which is filled with many ways to end your desktop session. It's also possible to leave using keyboard shortcuts. For example, pressing Ctrl-Alt-Delete will bring up a window which contains most of the options from this menu. You can also lock your computer by pressing Ctrl-Alt-L, though you can modify this in the system settings. Let me lock my computer now. If I had a screensaver enabled, you'd be seeing that now. Moving my mouse brings up a password prompt, though this window also allows me to start a new session as the same or a different user. By typing my password, I can return to my desktop, which will appear precisely as I left it. I would suggest learning about all the keyboard shortcuts available in Kubuntu, as they can make it much faster to perform certain common tasks in your computer. Probably the most used application today is the web browser. And just like every other popular computing topic, there are many options. Kubuntu comes with a web browser called Reconk. It has a simple interface, but comes fully equipped with a WebKit rendering engine and, if you choose to install third-party applications when you install Kubuntu, Flash. If you did not install third-party programs, opening Reconk will bring up a notification in your system tray alerting you that you don't have Flash. It will lead you through the steps required to install Flash at that point. Of course, you're welcome to install another browser if you'd like. It's easier to install another browser using the software management tool. Another crucial part of computing today is email. While of course you're welcome to use Gmail or another webmail client while you use Kubuntu, Contact is a fully featured personal information management suite which handles email, contacts, your calendar, news feeds, and much, much more. If you're used to using Evolution, Apple Mail, Outlook, or Thunderbird, you'll probably find yourself right at home in Contact very quickly. But what's a computing session without a little bit of music? To this end, Kubuntu comes with a program that I feel beats the competition on any platform, Amarok. Opening Amarok for the first time, we're going to be greeted with a pop-up telling us that the extra features are available. Had we not chosen to install Flash when we installed Kubuntu, we would have got a similar pop-up when we opened Reconk, allowing us to install Flash. It's very simple to install these extra features. We just click the downloading globe, press Install selected, type our passwords, and the installation will occur for us. The extra functionality we're installing here will allow us to play music and videos encoded in formats that, for legal or technical reasons, don't get installed by default. I'll let this installer run in the background. Once it finishes, I'll simply need to quit and reopen Amarok, and I'll have all the additional functionality the package has added. In the meantime, I'd like to speak to you about a program that often gets forgotten, the file manager. and what a treat Kubuntu's File Manager is. It brings the best features of file managers seen elsewhere. Of course, it's easy to get started and works just like one would expect of a file manager. Just like Mac users have iChat, so too do Kubuntu users have a wonderful built-in instant messaging program. It's called Kopete and is a truly remarkable program. Kopete will allow you to chat with others using over a dozen protocols. Got a friend who uses Windows Messenger? Connect your account. AOL users? Not a problem, you can connect to AIM as well. More a fan of Google? Google Talk's available too. It even has options for people who need to communicate in formulas, or when you have a private conversation. You're probably thinking, but what about when I need to work? Well, Kubuntu comes with one of the world's most powerful office suites, Libreoffice. You can do your word processing in it, or build a spreadsheet, or make a beautiful presentation. It even comes with a host of templates, allowing you to give your presentation a very human look. But I almost forgot about the most important program on your computer, a program that, in my experience, will never lose its usefulness, the Help Center. Every time I install an application with which I'm unfamiliar, I read its manual. In it, I find all sorts of awesome features that I would never have otherwise discovered. I would highly recommend becoming familiar with the KDE Help Center, as it's often a much quicker way to answer your questions than finding someone else to ask. Although, if you do need to ask someone, one of the best places to go is the #Kubuntu channel on the Ubuntu IRC server. You can connect to it through Quassel. Following the Quassel first run wizard in Kubuntu will set you up to join the #Kubuntu channel, which, in turn, will let you ask questions of members in the Kubuntu community. And who knows, you might be able to answer some questions that somebody else asks. I hope this has been an informative tutorial. My next tutorial will discuss installing applications.